Hello everyone, today we are making a dessert pizza. It's been a while since I've done one on the channel, and I figured since it's apple season, it's a great time to do an apple dessert pizza. So, let's get started. The first thing we're going to make is crumb topping for the pizza. Using a fork, we'll need to mix 1/2 a stick of cut up butter, 1/2 cup of all-purpose flour, and 1/4 cup of light brown sugar. It can take a few minutes to get everything completely mixed, but you'll know it's done when the mixture is in small pieces and crumbly. This is something that you'll usually see on top of pies or muffins, and it also works really well with what we're making today. The goal is to have enough to completely cover the apples in our pizza. Now we'll just put this in a sealed container and leave it in the fridge until later. Moving on to the next topping, we're going to take 4 ounces of softened cream cheese and 1/2 tablespoon of sugar and combine it with a mixer for a few minutes before adding in 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla. Since this will be easier to add to the pizza at room temperature, we're just going to let it set out until we need it. Now for the main topping of our delicious dessert, we're going to have to peel and core 2 apples. If you're going to make this at home, feel free to pick the 2 apples that you enjoy the most. Personally, I find using 2 different apples and having different textures and flavors gets incredible results. Today I'm going to use a Granny Smith for its firm texture and tart flavor, and pair it with a Golden Delicious for a soft texture and because it isn't too sweet. Once the apples are peeled and cored, cut them into thin slices. If you're using 1 firm and 1 soft apple like I am, then you can cut the softer apple into slightly thicker slices to help it cook more evenly with the firm apple. Next, turn the slices and cut them into small pieces and mix them in a bowl with 1 teaspoon of lemon juice. Now we're going to cook the apples with 2 tablespoons of butter on medium heat for about 4 to 5 minutes. You'll know the apples are done when you can poke them with a fork and it goes through them without any effort. Finish up the apples by mixing in 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, and just a few dashes of allspice, and let it cook for just a couple more minutes. Our final topping is a maple caramel sauce. To make it, we just need to melt 1 tablespoon of butter and mix it with 1/4 cup of brown sugar, 1/2 tablespoon of regular sugar, and 2 tablespoons of whipping cream. Let the mixture simmer for a couple of minutes, and then remove it from the heat. Once it's cooled down a bit, add 1/4 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla, and 1 tablespoon of pure maple syrup. Alright, let's get this pizza made. Lay out a pizza dough that is about 10 inches in diameter on top of your pizza peel. I'll leave a link to my dough recipe down below. Spread the cooked apples evenly across the dough. Now we're going to cover the whole thing with crumb topping. Be generous with the crumbs when adding it to your pizza. You should completely cover the apple toppings so that they are barely visible under all the crumbs. Now I'll bake the pizza as it is for about 5 to 6 minutes at 500 degrees Fahrenheit. While we give the pizza a chance to cool, let's make a piping bag for the cream cheese topping. Scoop the cream cheese into a plastic bag and push it into one of the corners. Twist the top of the bag closed and force out any air to keep the cream cheese from falling out. Now cut a small opening in the corner of the bag and use the bag to make circles or any pattern you prefer on your pizza. I'm also going to make a mental note to improve my piping skills before doing this on video again. Finally, use a spoon to drizzle the maple caramel sauce across the pizza. Use as much sauce as you'd like. Now we'll just cut the dessert into 8 slices, and it's ready to be enjoyed. So that's how you make an apple dessert pizza. Of course, there are many ways you can make it. This is just the one that I prefer. Let me know how you guys enjoy your apple desserts in the comments down below. Also, if you guys enjoyed the video, please click the like button and subscribe so that way you can see when the next video goes live. I'll see you guys next week.